Hi, I'm Jeff Giller. I'm the head of StepStone Real Estate. StepStone Real Estate's a real estate solutions provider, and we do it by providing asset management products and advisory services to our clients. And traditionally, asset management and advisory has been separated, and many thought that there were conflicts if it weren't separated, but more and more asset management and advisory solutions are being combined in firms. And there's many benefits to it, and there can be conflicts, but we feel if the business is structured correctly and the conflicts are considered, they can be properly mitigated. And in many cases, they just don't exist where people think that they might exist. Let me explain the differences as we see them between asset management and advisory services. We construct portfolios of real estate for our clients, and we do that by investing in funds, secondaries, and co-investments. Our funds are usually accessed through advisory services, so we'll advise clients on which funds to invest in. And then we help to generate alpha for their portfolios through secondaries and co-investments, which also help to eliminate the J-curve and allow you to make tilts into different products, markets, and sectors that you think are more attractive. Fund investments fit better, we believe, in the advisory model, and secondaries and co-investments in the asset management model. We believe the best benefit to our clients is that you get more access, you get more information about how managers are performing and their capabilities by doing co-investments and secondaries with them, so that you will actually learn more about, you know, whether it's a positive or negative to make a primary investment in their funds by having executed secondaries and co-investments with them. So we believe that that's a great benefit to our client. We've been able to test drive the manager before allocating discretionary capital to their funds. Another big advantage to our investors is that our pipeline of secondaries and co-investments is more robust because we have made investments in the manager's funds. So we would be hopefully first to see secondary and co-investment transactions that come out of the funds we've invested in, and that, you know, provides deal flow that benefit our clients. So like anything else, the more transactions you get a chance to look at, the better you can cherry pick the best ones. So having invested in the funds through our advisory relationships just gives us a more robust pipeline of deals on the secondary and co-investment side, which is the asset management side of the business. Traditionally, the market's been concerned about a perceived conflict between asset management and advisory. And the conflict would be that as an asset manager, I would compete with the manager that I'm underwriting for my client. That client therefore might not give me access to information that would help the institution that I'm advising. However, the way we address that conflict is we don't compete with managers. Our asset management business is strictly focused on secondaries and co-investments. So actually, we're accretive to the manager. They look at us as a liquidity source across various needs they have. For example, we invest in their funds through our advisory services. We make primary commitments to funds. We help their investors or their LPs create liquidity within their funds through our secondaries investment programs. And we help them right-size their deals through co-investments. So we actually don't compete with managers, which means that we get open access to information that helps us better serve our the clients we advise. If we competed with a manager, you know, in the market, if we were a direct investor, yeah, then there would be a conflict. But that's really one way we mitigate that conflict. So another conflict people are concerned about is that as an advisor and asset manager, you'll be incented to recommend your own funds to your clients. The way we mitigate that conflict is by simply not doing it. We have strict rules against recommending our own funds to our clients. On occasion, they will ask, because they'll know about our products, they'll ask if they can gain access to our funds. If they do, we'll certainly allow them to do that. We won't restrict them, but we'll make sure that they hire another advisor, a third-party advisor, to evaluate our products for their benefit. Another conflict people are concerned about is that we'll allocate the best opportunities to our asset management products at the expense of the clients that we advise. And it's really not the case, since our asset management products are really just secondaries and co-investments, and we don't advise clients on their investments in secondaries and co-investments. We really, if they want access to secondaries and co-investments, they would come in through our separate accounts or commingled funds. So there's really no conflicts about the allocations.